Hello everyone. In the previous topics, we have learned the instruction set of 8088/8086 microprocessor. We discussed a number of instructions with respect to questions like what are the input operands of the instruction, what is the processing performed by this instruction, what results are produced by the instruction, where these results are stored, what addressing mechanism is used to specify source and destination operands. These important aspects were discussed for every instruction of 8086/8088 microprocessor covered earlier. Going forward, today we will learn how to write assembly language programs using these instructions. Let us take a problem of adding two 64-bit numbers. As all of us are aware that 8086 or 8088 microprocessor does not contain a single instruction to perform addition of two 64-bit operands, because there is no instruction available. So, we have to write a program so that we can accomplish the addition of two 64-bit numbers. And as we can observe, if we add two 64-bit numbers, the addition of two 64-bit numbers can at most result in a 65-bit number. That means, if two numbers are 64 bits, the addition cannot be more than 2 to the power 65, or 65 bits are enough to store the result. So, typically when the addition is performed, the addition of two 64-bit result, if it is a 65th bit, it can result in a carry. For storage of 64-bit number, we will use 8-byte memory locations each to store the pair of 64-bit numbers, and we will also use 8-byte memory locations for storing the result, as the result also will be stored in a sequence of 8 memory location. The convention followed for storing 64-bit numbers is that the first 8 least significant bits are stored in first memory location. The second 8 bit can be stored in the subsequent memory location, and so on. Therefore, in order to perform 64-bit addition, we must be clear of the program logic and the sequence of the steps necessary to solve the problem of 64-bit addition. The only thing required is to organize the logic of the problem solution through the step-by-step description of the instructions we have learned earlier. The step-by-step description for solving a problem is also called algorithm and is pictorially represented through a flowchart. From the memory representation of 64-bit pair of operands, it is clear and evident that we must first add a pair of 64-bit number, as the instruction for adding a pair of 64-bit number is directly available in 8086/8088 instruction set. If the first pair of 16-bit addition results in a carry, then next pair of numbers should be added along with a carry bit too, and so on. So, let us start with the problem description. It is required to add two 64-bit numbers. Let these 64-bit numbers are 62B4, 12A4, 02A4, 1234. That means, we are representing 64-bit number as 4 set of 16-bit number, and in 4 such 16-bit numbers, the first is 62B4, second is 12A4, third is 02A4, fourth is 1234, and another number is say 3002, 5204, 5204, 1234, 1234, 0214H represented in hexadecimal format. And for this, we first initialize the register with 400H, so that 400 bytes is the offset from the start of the data segment register. The least significant 16 bits of the first number are stored in the memory location pointed to by the register SI and SI plus 1. We get this result using the first two instructions, move SI comma 400, as the source index register is initialized to a value 400x, and then we use the second instruction that the immediate operand 1, 2, 3, 4 assigned with the instruction move SI, where SI is written in the square brackets, comma 1, 2, 3, 4. The contents 1, 2, 3, 4 hex are now transferred to the memory location pointed to by SI as well as SI plus 1. After the execution of this instruction, the offset address 400H contains 34 hex and the address 0401 hex contains the number 12 hex. Then we increment SI by 2 using the instruction add SI comma 02 instruction. The instruction move SI comma 02A4H stores the 16 bit number in the subsequent location, and the subsequent locations are 0402 hex and 0403 hex respectively. The remaining instructions are self-explanatory in the sense that they will store the remaining 32 bit numbers in the memory locations 404 to 407 hex. The next 8 instruction, as you can see, transfer the second 64 bit number to the memory offset defined by the register DI from the location 500H to 507 hex. Next, in order to start the addition, SI and DI are again initialized to 400 and 500 hex respectively. The addition starts from the first pair of two 16 bit numbers. Since the four pair of 16 bit numbers are to be added, we initialize a counter CL to 04. The carry flag is cleared in the beginning through the CLC instruction. The first 16 bit number is brought to the register AX from memory buffer pointed by SI through the instruction move AX comma SI. Next, the AX is added with carry flag to the contents of the memory buffer pointed to by the register DI. The result so obtained is also stored in the memory buffer pointed to by the register SI. Both SI and DI are then incremented by 02 so that they point to the next pair of 16 bit numbers. The CL, which is a counter register in this case, is decremented by 1 through DEC decrement CL instruction. The conditional jump JNZ is performed only when 0 flag is set to 1, and the 0 flag is set to 1 when the result of the decrement operation is 0 as discussed earlier. The program can be easily extended for 128 bit addition by storing first 8 16 bit numbers in the memory instead of just 4 16 bit numbers for 64 bit addition. Also, the loop for addition will iterate 8 times instead of 4 times for 64 bit addition. That means the register CL must be initialized to 8 instead of 4 for 128 bit addition operation. Let us take the example of another program to find sum of n elements. We assume there are 200 data elements stored in the memory buffer having offset defined by the register SI. Accordingly, the register CL is initialized to a value C8 hex, which is equivalent of decimal 200. Next, we have to either initialize the memory buffer by some data values, or we can fill up the values by writing a program which stores numbers in some sequence. Let us say our number sequence start with a number AB hex. So, the register BL is initialized to AB to start with. Next, we transfer the contents of BL to the memory buffer by the instruction move SI in square brackets, we are writing SI in square brackets comma BL, so that the contents of BL are transferred to a memory location pointed to by SI, not to SI. Then both BL and SI are incremented by 1 through the instructions increment BL and increment SI respectively. Next, the counter CL is decremented by 1 through DEC CL instruction. The instruction jump if not 0 perform a conditional jump only when the 0 flag is set to 1. The 0 flag is set to 1 when the result of decrement operation DEC CL is 0. That means the conditional jump takes place 200 times in this case. Initial value of CL was 200. The CL is decremented by 1 in every iteration till it is reduced to 0. Thus, filling values starting from 11 hex, 12 hex, 13 hex to D8 hex. In the next instruction sequence, again we initialize the register CL to 200 decimal by the instruction move CL comma C8H. Initialize register AL to 00 through the instruction move H comma 00 hex. Initialize register SI to 400H through the instruction move SI comma 400H, so that the source index register SI points to the start of the memory buffer offset. The instruction move AL comma SI, where SI is put in bracket, brings the first element from the memory buffer pointed to by SI to the register AL. The SI is then incremented by 1, so that the second element from memory buffer onwards can be brought in. The next instruction adds the contents of the register AL with the location pointed to by the register SI. The higher order 8 bit register AH is incremented by 1 if carry flag is set to 1 during the previous add operation. That means the program logic is, we add the contents of the memory buffer register one by one to the register AL. Since register AL is only 8 bits, it cannot hold a 16 bit value, and final result of summation of 200 elements may be total 16 bits. Therefore, if a carry is generated during the process of addition operation, the contents of register AH are incremented by 1. This is accomplished by the following instruction sequence. We have written jump if no carry to next, and then we are writing increment H. That means if no carry is generated, don't increment and perform a conditional jump operation, jump if no carry to next. But if a carry is generated, jump if no carry results in a false, therefore it does not jump. And therefore, the next instruction in the sequence increment AH is executed, resulting in the increment of register contained AH by 1. And it is as per the program logic which is explained earlier. The overall, the program for finding the sum of n numbers as explained can be summarized as ORG 100H move SI comma 400. Move CL comma C8H, move BL comma 11H loop. This loop sequence move SI comma BL, increment BL, increment SI, decrement CL, jump if not 0 loop. As you can see this program snippet, the purpose of this program is to initialize the contents of the memory buffer by values starting from 11 hex to 12 hex, then 13 hex, 14 hex and so on till all 200 elements are filled up in the memory buffer. And the purpose of next program's snippet, which starts from move CL comma C7, which again initializes the value of CL to 199, as we have to iterate only 199 times, because the first element is stored in the register AL and the remaining 199 elements are to be added to the register AL. and this loop 1 is iterated 199 times through the counter value C7, and every time, as you can see, we are incrementing SI. We are adding the contents of the memory location pointed to by SI to register AL through add AL comma SI instruction, and we perform a jump operation only if no carry is generated. Otherwise, if a carry is generated, we increment the register AH, and for jumping back to loop 1, we decrement the contents of CL. So, this is how this program is executed, and in between you can also write an instruction increment SI, because every time you have to add new element. The above program for finding the sum of n elements can be easily modified to find the minimum of n elements. The instruction add AL comma SI is required to be changed to compare AL comma SI. And if the AL is greater than or equal to SI, a carry flag is set to 0, else the carry flag is set to 1. In case of the carry flag is set to 1, we declare the current contents of the register AL as the new minima by the instruction move AL comma SI. That means, if this is now new minima, it is stored in the register AL. Also copy the current index position stored in BL to CH, so that the contents of the register CH indicate the position where the minimum was found. The register BL is initialized to 1 in the beginning through the instruction move BL comma 01. So, the revised program for finding minimum looks like this. As we initialize, we use a term ORG 100H to indicate the program starts from 100 location, and then we again initialize SI to 400. We initialize move CL to a value C8H through the instruction move CL comma C8H. We initialize register BL by a value 11 hex, and this program snippet again initializes the memory buffer contents starting with SI to 11H, 12H, 13H till all the 200 elements are filled in as explained earlier. But the only change, as you can observe, we have done is we are assuming AL is the minimum to start with. Every time we are bringing in a new element SI and we are comparing the contents of AL with SI, and if the AL is greater than SI, we do not perform anything. As you can see, the second program snippet starting with loop 1, which starts with increment SI, and then it is comparing AL with memory location pointed to by SI. And if the memory location pointed to by SI is less than the current contents of AL, then that content of memory buffer is the new minima, and therefore, since AL, if it is less than SI, a carry is generated. That means, we have to perform the operation move AL comma SI. Otherwise, if no carry is generated, we can move to the next label as indicated in the jump if no carry next statement. And also, when a new minima is obtained, we store the position of that new minima, which is currently held in the register BL, to the register CH, so that in the end of the program execution, we get the minimum value in the register AL first, and also the position where this minimum exists in the memory buffer in the register CH, which is indicated that whenever a new minima is found, we store the new minima in the register AL, and we also store the position of its element in the register CH. And then to perform the loop operation, we decrement CL and say jump if not 0 to loop. So, in the end, you get the minimum value from the memory buffer in the register AL and the position of this minimum value in the memory buffer in the register CH. The next program demonstrates the use of lookup table. A lookup table is a table required in many business scientific applications for mapping from one set of values to another set of values. Let there be a lookup table for converting ASCII code to abstract code. We prepare a table in such a manner that the abstract equivalent of the ASCII code 65 exists at 65th place in the table. Also, the abstract equivalent of the ASCII code 66 and onwards exists at 66th place and onwards. Suppose we organize such a table containing abstract codes. Given an ASCII code, we can immediately locate the corresponding ASCII code from the table so formed. An instruction xlet b in 8086/8088 helps to efficiently implement the above operation. The xlet b converts the register contents al as al equal to address, because see ds0 plus bx plus al is referred to as address in the memory buffer. And how this address is computed? DS is a 16 bit register as explained earlier, append 4 bits in the last to this data segment register DS and make it a 20 bit register, add the content of BX which is used as an offset which indicates the start of the table, and then add the contents of register AL. Overall, these three operands when added together generate a 20 bit address, and the contents of 20 bit address memory location are transferred to the register AL. In other words, the register contents AL are replaced by the contents of the memory location pointed to by the address computed by data segment with 4 bits appended in the last, added with the contents of the offset register BX and AL. The following program snippet does the task of converting the given value into its equivalent value from the lookup table. As you can see, the first instruction is LEA BX comma date. It loads the register BX with the starting address of the table DAT. Then we initialize register AL with 02 through the instruction move AL comma 02. The DAT has a label declare byte, and through the label and the DB facility, we are initializing the elements, 5 elements. That means through declare byte, we are trying to say that next 5 memory elements are reserved starting with date, and these 5 elements contains 11, 22, 33, 44, and 55. These 5 elements are stored in the 5 consecutive memory bytes in the storage area starting with the label DAT. And after we execute the instruction xlet b, this xlet b will convert the given value in AL, which is 02, to the value from the table, and stores now 33 hex in the AL. As you can see, third element in the table is 33. So, this 33 value will be stored in the register AL after the execution of this statement. All the above programs can be tested using an emulator called EMU8086, which is downloadable from the internet free for evaluation and testing purpose. EMU8086 is a microprocessor emulator with an integrated 8086 assembler and free tutorial. Emulator runs programs on a virtual machine. It emulates real hardware such as screen, memory, and input-output devices. EMU8086 microprocessor and 8086 assembler is licensed as shareware for Windows operating system platform and can be used as a free trial until the trial period ends after few specified number of days. So, what we have learned today is how to develop logic using the assembly instructions we have learned in the previous topics. Using the logic, a program to add 264 bit numbers was developed. Each and every step of the logic helps you not only to understand the problem of 64 bit addition, but helps you to think about attempting solution to more complex problems using the available instructions. Thank you.